So we are past the trade deadline, and we have now got the Minnesota Wild. And in the last three games, we've at least scored four goals in each of the last three games. Remember, this game against St. Louis went to a shootout, and it seemed like this game would never end. But so we didn't score five in that game. We scored four by the end of regulation. And then we've dominated Buffalo, and we straight up dominated the Ottawa Senators. We scored five goals in the last two games in a row, and we didn't even need an empty netter, I think, to get there. Did we have an empty netter against Ottawa? I don't think so. My memory does not recall. I don't think we did. But anyway, we are playing great offensively, and I know we've had two clunkers here against the Oilers and against the New Jersey Devils, but we've gotten it right. We just seem to always get the train right back on the tracks, coming off of some tough games. Oh yeah, the blue jerseys are back. We've only worn them one other time. This will probably be the last time we break these out for the season. I just thought that I'd change it up a little bit and wear these jerseys for the first time since I think we played St. Louis the last time we wore these jerseys, and get a good look at them while you can, because I think this is it. This will be the last time we wear them on the season. I'm not a big fan of these, but again, I just kind of thought I'd change it up a little bit. And we're coming off of some really stellar performances against our opponents. We played a couple of Eastern Conference teams. Now we're facing, I think we played all the Eastern Conference teams we have to play on the whole season, as we just closed out a road game again. Whoa. That's behind Hornquist. That's unfortunate. That's a saucer pass to Wilson to put him in a vulnerable position. But I think all of our opponents from here to the end of the season are Western Conference teams. So, get ready to see a lot of the same teams that we've already played. Going to be forming a few rivalries. Detroit is on that slate, and so is Colorado a couple of times. We have a couple of back-to-backs with some of these teams. Home and home, back-to-back, coming up toward the end of the schedule here as we're getting toward the end of the season. And this is about the time right now we want to be playing our best hockey, playing some excellent hockey. Good play, Kostitsyn, turnaround. He's got no speed to really do anything. So we'll just hammer that high off of Backstrom. I think it's Backstrom in the net. I didn't pay that much attention to who's tending the goal crease. That's a good pass. Poorly defended. And a goal. I saw that coming a mile away. I jumped up with, I don't know who I jumped up with. Was it Blum? No, it wasn't Blum. It was Josi. I missed it with Josi. And I put Blum in a very difficult position, having to defend a 2-on-1. I tried to give Rene the shot, and he just didn't handle it. Posting in as well by Bouchard. Great shot, number 96. And you just don't see many people wearing number 96, do you? I mean, we can handle being down in a game. I mean, a little adversity isn't so bad. I don't want to play a horrible game. See, if we lose games, whatever. You know, I don't want to get dominated in losing games. There's no pride in getting dominated. There's pride in giving an honest effort and losing, and we can say, hey, we gave it our best shot, and we still lost the game. We're going to lose some games before the season does end, but I don't want to lose if we can help it, and I want to give a straight effort. And this has not been a good effort to start the game, clearly. Palmville. So defense is going to have to clean it up. We're going to have to figure a way into the attacking zone. I didn't mean to do that. And in not meaning to do that, I have set Blum up to just hammer it off of Mikko Koivu. God, his name is a bit of a tongue twister for me. This is some interesting passing. I just didn't like where that went. I tried to do too much with Hornquist. Would have been better off just shooting the puck. Just get it toward the net. Hornquist is going to help us out. We'll go behind the net to Blum. D to D. And forward. Puck's got to go forward. That's a risky spot. and a risky pass. It's going to go back into the Minnesota zone. So clearly, nice hit there in the background. Clearly, we're a little slow to start. We don't have our foot speed. We've had a few days off in the game world since the last game, so maybe we're a little rusty. Guys are not so nervous now about being traded since we're past the deadline, even though there are no trades. Trust me, none of you are going anywhere except for the IR if you get injured bad enough. And please, no one get injured bad enough, because we've already got two guys on the IR basically until season's end. So, oh, what a sidestep. I put Kostitsyn in that spot where he had to make that move. Hal Gill, nice deflection. Oh, I wanted... I just said something about the IR. Are you kidding me? It's a centerman as well. It's our number one center. It's Mike Fisher. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, no, no. Not like this. Not like this. That's literally the worst injury. That is literally, aside from Kostitsyn, that is literally, honestly, the worst injury that we could have. We've taken a penalty. I want to tell you, we're missing David Legwan, who is, you can argue who's the number one center, because they've both played the number one center position. Legwan and Fisher, that is, both of those guys have both played first line center this year at certain points. With Legwan gone, then Mike Fisher is the de facto number one center. He is, oh, that's a penalty 100% of the way. That is definitely a penalty. I will take that break. And who's number seven? Is that Cullen? No, that's not Cullen. It is Cullen. Okay, so it is Matt Cullen. I didn't remember how long Matt Cullen played in Minnesota for. He's been all over the place. Obviously, 2006 Stanley Cup champion with the Carolina Hurricanes. I remember him fondly from that, but I also remember him in his Pittsburgh days. This is before his Pittsburgh days. They are all over us in this game. Just please, nice try. Weber's trying to tee one up. Blum, good keep in, and then he messed it up. Bouchard going for number two. But God, Weber's not even skating. I'm pressing the speed burst button, and he's not even skating. Oh my goodness, this team is lollygagging to start this game, and we're missing Mike Fisher. That hurts so much. I guess Colin Wilson. Who's the number one center on this team now? Is it Colin Wilson? It's not Paul Gostad. He's not the number one center. I got to figure that out. Depending on how long Fisher's gone. You hope for, at the worst, that it's not much more than maybe 2 weeks. I could probably handle him being gone for 2 weeks. But someone's going to have to pick up that number one center role. And you're going to have to do a good job. Oh, it's on the doorstep. Fed through the crease. Weber's on it. Kicks it down low to Wilson. We're going to have to sidestep. Oh, what a move by Wilson. Oh! Oh! Oh, blocked. I was hoping for more. Nice play. This is the best possession of the whole game. We can't keep it in. That's okay. Shea Weber, you can't get hurt. And neither can Kostitsyn. You're not allowed to get hurt. You're simply just not allowed to get hurt. Oh, it's there, Bork. There it is. Well, they didn't know where it was. There we go. We'll hand it off for Weber. Walk the line. Drop past the Bork. Over to Weber. Intended for Blum. Blum. Oh! Goodness gracious, this team. This team. We're looking... Weber, can he get around? He's trying to dart away from the pressure. Open up them hips. Fire. I don't care if you get hurt, if you're a Minnesota player. I don't care. You will take your losses. We cannot lose any more players. What line is this? Is this truly the fourth line? Because people are going to be getting double shifted. Someone's going to be getting double minutes at center in this game. What a move by Alishuk. These moves have been working tonight. And he missed it. Get in there. Go, Rich Klune. He's trying. Take it to the net. This is going to become one of those games where I'm just going to be uber frustrated. I didn't even know that was dumped in. Truthfully, I had no idea that was even dumped in until the last minute. Bank it off the boards. There we go. Why are you kneeling? Paul Gostad. Move to the outside. Shake him off. Oh, I knew that was coming. Oh my goodness! How did that not go in? Goodness gracious, this team can't buy a bounce right now. What is this? Oh, that's the chance Halischuk. I can't buy a bounce. Had a look over the glove and he missed it. So, Spaling could be a good candidate. Someone's moving up the lineup as far as center is concerned. And then Nick Spaling, you may become the second line center or the first line center. I don't know who's out there that's an option. I'm telling you, I'm pulling this move off tonight. Someone want to get in that front? Oh, it's off of the goaltender, and it went behind the net. Can we keep it in with Kuminski? We do. Oh, too much. I was there. Oh, I was a little hopeful. I was maybe a little too hopeful. Oh, Rene's got it. Brilliant man. Way to go. Someone get open in the neutral ice. Between the legs, the drop to Smith to Forsberg. Oh, where do you think I'm going with this? To the net. Oh, man, he got bumped right in the backstrom. Forsberg, turn around, go get in the play. I don't even care if you're out of gas. We got a chance to keep the puck in. Let's do it. Do it to him. I think he went on a line change, so we couldn't keep it in. And that's rimmed too hard for Rene, but that's fine. Oh, go. I got Craig Smith with a lot of room, lots of space. Craig Smith to the inside, to the middle. Trying to just shake off defenders. Oh, Craig Smith's poor ankles or feet or whatever that hit. We're having a lot of shots blocked, and it's our own fault for a lot of these. I thought that was a wild player. I think wearing blue against these dark green Minnesota jerseys was not very helpful because the contrast is pretty sharp on my television. And it's, oh, that's a penalty. It's kind of hard to tell the green apart from the blue, to be honest. Should have just worn yellow. We're wearing yellow for the rest of the season. We should have just worn yellow. It would have been our good luck jerseys. But we're kind of all over the place. And Colin Wilson is second. Oh, we're killing a penalty. That's right. I forgot about the penalty kill. So we didn't actually officially start this penalty kill. Wait, did we start this penalty kill before? Oh, my goodness. Before this. Third or second period started. It's not even the third period yet. I don't know what I'm talking about. Weber out off the back end and right out. Good play. Good man. Oh, my goodness. I didn't know Backstrom was going to be that sloppy with it. Hal Gill so slow. Shouldn't even be killing penalties. Oh, Rene. Cover. Did we change? Yeah, we did. We changed. Who's paired with Josi on this kill? Bobby Butler. One of the best penalty killers on his team, believe it or not, all season, and he just couldn't quite get to that. He wouldn't have had a chance. He would have been broken free. No, cover the net front. Behind you. Oh, my goodness. This team, get it out. Out. And it is out. It's enough. It gives us a breath. Pound him. Get on him. If you're a forward, you need to be up there and on top of these guys in the neutral zone. All right, I'm looking for that. We can skate this a little bit. We can actually skate this all the way. Drop out. Boom. Hallis, Chuck, get around them. They're chasing you. Whoa. That was an interesting windmill. But we killed the penalty. Hey, that's a positive. It's a net positive right now. We killed the penalty. We got to look for little positives in this game right now. When a game is not really to our advantage, you just got to find a little positive where you can find one. Eventually, we're going to get our game together. I think we're just going to have to dump the puck in at times. Minnesota's been very good through the neutral zone, and they're very good at defending us off the rush. Just got to find options. There it is. Spaling, you should have shot it. He's stick handling like a goof. Shoot it. Blum, turn. That was a weak wrister, but hey, sometimes a weak wrister, it leads to a penalty. Sometimes that weak wrister can still get through, and this will be our first official... Is this our first official power play? Because I know that we had the 4-on-4 scenario, and we may have had like 4 seconds where we were technically on the power play, but we're not. Yeah, we're 0-for-1. We're technically 0-for-1, but it wasn't even really a power play. Anyway, whatever. We're on the power play now, and we need it. Oh my goodness, Craig Smith. They're just so good on that blue line. When you have the defenseman with the... Technically, it's a forward as a defenseman. On that, when you have the point guy, we'll just say that. When you have the point guy with the puck at the blue line, my God, it's shorthanded for them, and we look like this. Drive the net. I have no net drive. Blum. Oh, my goodness. This team is so bad. Weber's been slow tonight. Slow to get back to these pucks. Opposite side of where Blum is. And we're just, I'll tell you, we're having the most careless power play I've ever seen. Fake shot. Well, self-pass. There was no need for that. All this spinning around you're doing. You're just wasting it. Oh, my goodness. Great. Get off the ice. Just get off the ice. Power play doesn't even have a shot. We need to take a shot on net. Just take a shot. Goodness gracious. Get a shot. God, this is the weakest power play. Oh, you're gonna go at me? No, you're not gonna go at me. You are gonna face repercussions for that. You're about to get number 19 right in the face. Come on, Butler, throw your best punches. And he does knock out Brodin. Message sent. We might need that. I think we actually need that. I mean, we're not going to have but 5 seconds of power play time now, but we needed that. We need an energy boost, and it needs to come from somewhere, and somebody has got to do something. Someone's got to do something differently. Maybe it's Roman Josi. And it is not Roman Josi. Skate in. Oh, he got torpedoed. The puck's in the goal crease, but it's not in. And if we keep poking away at it, we're going to really make these guys angry. I don't care. They can get angry if they want to. I don't care. I'm angry. I am angry at our team's effort, just in general, but especially that power play. Goodness gracious. This is what we've dealt with the whole season. Oh. Minnesota's really giving it to us. How do we miss a saucer pass like that? Get in there, Rich Klun. Scandella, fold him. Fold me. Oh, what a play by Halichuk. It's just a shame we're offside, technically. Blum can't get around three defenders. He was in a very tough spot. He had to try something there. I'm going to come back through the middle here. Oh, that's an icing. This is one of those times you need to skate, Weber. I'll just change it up all the way. Second pair and first line. Who's the first line center? Wilson. Colin Wilson. He's getting double shifted, which is fine. He might become the first line center. With the injury to, we don't know what the injury to Craig Smith to Mike Fisher looks like. Craig Smith is not on the ice, or not injured. He's on the ice. I'm getting everything backwards right now. He is on the ice. He's not injured. And, just third forward line, whatever. Whoever's the freshest, get on the ice and make a difference. I mean, I think what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to hold on to this, wrap it around. Forsberg can't buy a break. He's had so many good looks through a stretch of games, and nothing's just going in for him. He looks good out here. He looks like he belongs. He definitely belongs. I mean, with injuries, someone's going to have to make a difference in this lineup. We're just get rattled with injuries through the center position. And Forsberg could shift over and play center, but I think his face-off statistic is not, his attribute for face-offs is not great. I'm going to sky this one cross corner. So you got to go in there, Forsberg. This is where you can make your money. Good forecheck. There you go. And backdoor. Oh. Oh. This is getting away from me, this game. We had a great setup, too. The forecheck was there, and I just slapped my knee. Gabriel Bork with a knee slapper penalty. I was about to say, we have two guys in the box, but I forgot Butler had a fight just a few moments ago. We'll be rejoining the game shortly. Weber, we can take our time with this. We can take our sweet time with this. And I'm just going to, boom, down the ice. See if Backstrom messes this up. Oh, whoa! He has had some really sketchy times playing that puck tonight. Al Gill. Oh, Weber, you're on the spot. That's a good play by Weber. Change it up, though. Get Hal Gill off the ice. He's so slow. Why is he so slow? Oh, Klein, he had it. If they score, I'm going to feel really dumb. Oh. Ugh. Man. Time to change the neutral zone. What were we? Whatever. I don't care what we were. Let's be 1-4 and no more pinching. God. And I hate it because Klein's computer-controlled player didn't really do much wrong other than he was beat by the forward in the neutral zone. But he made a play on the puck. He got his stick on it. And it didn't matter. Deflected right to Setoguchi. Just an unlucky, ill-timed play. And we're just being... Our hand is being forced by Minnesota right now. I've not seen us just look this bad since the game against St. Louis. That's a good play by Bork. I mean, we got to try something, man. Puck's got to start going just simply to the net. I don't care where it's from, where the shot comes from. We're going to have to start shooting more. But see, we've got our D playing back a little more aggressive or more conservative. And we're not letting these guys stretch the ice as much, which has been a big problem with this game. What a move! What a move by Forsberg. I didn't think he was going to get pushed down. He went skate to stick with that. I didn't even know that that was a deke that I could do. Oh, yeah! Get taken to Pound Town. That was a nice hit. That was a beautiful hit. Bork off the rush. Blocked, though. Get on there, Kostitz, and get on that side of the rink. And the Wild are away again. I do have, besides the neutral zone strategy, I have defensemen set to pinch more. Oh, I didn't mean to pass. Oh, maybe I did. Oh, man. It's just not going. Shoot it. Rebound. Oh, Kostitz. We are so close. We are millimeters away from just that one play we need to get a goal. Did I do too... Was I too fancy? Oh. No. I accidentally made that pass, and then it worked out, and then it didn't do anything. We don't look terrible. Like, we don't look awful right now. We've made a couple of mistakes defensively, and it's backfired. But we're playing much more conservative overall in the neutral zone. I still have defensemen set to, like, as a pairing. Are still set to pinch. There was no way that was going to ever hit Hornqvist. And again, Weber's just way too far up on the play. He makes a nice recovery hit. Go. None of you are freaking flying out of the zone. You're lucky that ended up on the stick of Backstrom. High Backstrom. Hornqvist wanted to say hello. Oh, it's just back and forth we go. That's a bad spot to have a odd bounce. Big block by Weber. He's out of position now. Oh, cover the point. Good block. Oh, good block. Two in a row on the same shift. Let's go. Turn it up. Oh, turn it up indeed. 2-11. Halaschuk? Yeah. I 10-2'd that. We needed that goal so bad. Man, I didn't expect that to go in. I was just throwing it for a rebound. We didn't need a rebound. Screw the rebound. How about put it in the back of the net, on the first attempt? And then the celly. There's a very brief celly. One knee celly. Oh, that's a sigh of relief. It took us that long to get number one. If it takes us that long to get one, are we even going to be good for three? This could be a very tight game to the end. We got to defend well. Keep this to a very low scoring affair, but because we don't know. We don't know how many goals we're going to be capped off at tonight. What a pass. Keep driving the net, Bork. You got to keep going hard to the net. Don't give up on that play. You want to score goals, you got to go there. You got to go through the front of the net. See how Yossi's really up on the blue line? It's worked out, and then it didn't. Oh, what a handle. That was a good handle by Klein around the guy. Forsberg, the pull-up. I got no friends. I got no one-timers. Just going to go to the corner and try to dig out this shift. That didn't work out very well, did it? Yeah, I just skated myself into that turnover. Yossi is really aggressive on the pinching. Stick on the ice. If you can make that short side save, we're good. Oh, we got to push it. Push the limit here. Drop pass. Kostitz and shoot it. Oh my goodness. Oh, bar and out. Bar out. Not bar down. This team has looked pretty decent. I mean, we look decent. We've been close on so many occasions. It's just not gone right for us on some of these plays. And we're still missing our first line center. Mike Fisher, he's gone definitely for the game. And for who knows how long beyond that. We're just going to chip that in. Good play just to get it in. Where's he going to go out? Outside. Good pressure by Butler. That's the right idea. And he's going to get back on the back check. And they're offside. So that's a good break for us. And is that a defensive zone faceoff? Yes, it is. It is a D-zone faceoff for Minnesota. That's a break. It's because the pass on the offside came from the D-zone. If you're wondering why that's a defensive zone faceoff, offside on a defensive zone pass, or a pass from the D zone, is a defensive zone faceoff on the ensuing faceoff. So, I couldn't get it through Stoner. Stay in there, Forsberg. Get after him. Yeah! And clean play as well. Blum, back down low. Oh, Forsberg was not the intended recipient. Oh my god, his handles are so slick. Sleek? Slick? I don't even know what word I'm trying to use. I gotta look in the dictionary. Someone want to get to the point? Someone want to get up here on the right side? No one's even on the right side. That's fine, Colin Wilson. Oh, I wanted to strip Gilbert of the puck. Dumped in again by the Minnesota Wild, Nashville, to retrieve. It, the breakout's on that side of the rink, so... Do you have any more handles? Oh, yeah, he's got these slick handles. Look at Phil Forsberg. Oh, my goodness. He's not even, like... He's, like, 73 overall or something, and he looks like this. My goodness gracious, I could do this all night. Oh! Oh, no! Don't be injured. Don't be injured. That was Forsberg as well. Don't be injured. Go. Oh, I tried to put it to him. I tried to give him the puck, trying to make an unselfish play with that. Get there. Yeah. Poke check the way. This line is good. Phil Forsberg. Oh, I think he's taking a penalty. Interference coming up. I think he's taking a penalty. But I'm going to have to give Phil Forsberg a freaking look on the first line. That's going to be tough because I'm going to have to move. I would have to move Craig Smith or Kostitsyn down. Obviously, Kostitsyn's not moving anywhere. But, man, he looks good. Aside from the penalty. And they called it slashing. I thought it was interference. I was in control of him on that penalty, too. I was just going a little too much. Just went a little too much. Do we go for it? Screw it. Let's go for it. Let's go for this. Halichuk again. Does he have the right moves? No, Backstrom with a save this time. Same 10-2 move. Didn't go in this time. Backstrom has his scouting report on Backstrom on Halichuk. Oh, that's gotta be fed through. And I don't know how he saw that or made a save. I mean, if you can even see, I don't even care if Shea Weber is wide open and you don't have a screen in front. If Shea Weber claps one toward you, you're lucky if you can even see the puck. You just kind of hope the puck hits you. Now I'm gonna try a little. Lost it. Lost the handle. I was just trying to get to the inside. We're killing a penalty here, so just as long as it's not a devastating turnover, we're welcome to try some things. Defenseman cannot vacate the front of the net for too long. Especially, don't just go chasing below the goal line. Oh, they passed it all the way out of the zone. Is that it for the penalty? Basically. 26 seconds, not a lot of time. Enough to get a rush, play going, and an offensive zone possession. But you have to hurry now. If they want to get that zone possession. Offside? Nope. Clean. It's definitely onside. But. Oh, that's not hard enough around the boards. I was trying to time it as Forsberg came out of the box. They hit the post. Just above the head of Rene. Back to the point. Other point guy. Butler. Big block, my man. Fresh out of the box is Forsberg. And he's got it. Up to Butler. Butler to move to the middle. These guys, these lower skill guys showing off the hands right now. And then they're not really doing much of anything with it beyond that. But they are showing off some hands. Nice handiwork. Oh! Got enough of it. I got enough of it. All right, good in there. Yeah. This is just teamwork. Good teamwork. Go over there, Gil. Oh, man. We're getting it on the back check. We're hungry for the puck right now. Nice play. Oh, bank pass. Or didn't even need one. Hold on to that thought. I was going to pass it. But you know what? Phil Forsberg. Oh, the moves. And it's off of Bork, I think. I don't even think that even got to the net. That's moved to the outside. Pominville read it perfectly. These dekes aren't going to work all night. Get there, get there, get there. Oh, Heatley's going to get there. Gill was way far back. It's pressure time now. It's going to be time to start pushing, man. Push like a pregnant woman giving birth. Go for that goal. Oh, floated way wide. We're going to try to move to the middle. Or move around the outside. Another move around the outside. The cutback. Oh, that's not working. Get it down low. We got to keep the puck moving into the attacking zone. I can't get surrounded by defenders trying to do too many stupid dekes. Oh, Weber's beat. He's just too slow getting back. It's been a very slow game for Weber. I'm shadowing this guy the whole way. Now I got to cover the front of the net. Yo, see, move it. Got help from the center. Good support. Where's that wing? Kostitsyn back up to Wilson. Pastita now. Wrist shot. It's a floaty wrist shot from outside. I wanted a slap shot, but I guess I didn't pull the stick back correctly. And are we just looking at Backstrom? What is this? Yeah, Backstrom. They're out to make this guy some sort of a king in this game, but honestly, we have not made this game as tough as we needed to on him. I mean, that's a nice save with the shoulder, but that's a floaty one from outside. We haven't pressured him enough. Maybe we need to start crashing the net, or maybe we need to grind a cycle. Who knows what this team really is going to need to get some more offense, but it's got to come from somewhere. You know, we have a lucky shot off the rush from Halaschuk with their little slap shot, doing 10-2. Little 10-2 move with the skates, or whatever you call it, mohawk, whatever you want to call it. Open up the hips. We're lucky to get that goal, but we're going to need more. We need more right now. This team needs to do more. Be hungry. Block it. Shot's not coming from there. It's coming from there. I don't know if I like giving the puck to Gill there. Ah, it's out of reach. Icing? Yeah, it's a little too much. 5.5. That's a lot of pressure, honestly. Let's change our forecheck a little bit. So we're going to be... Are we weak? Did it say weak side lock? I don't even know what it said. All right, so I'm the only one in with Butler. Yeah, that didn't go anywhere at all, did it? Oh, here we go, Gilt. See how they're stacking up? They're stacking up on the blue line. We just got to skate it in, Kuminsky. Floater, backhand floater, nothing wrong with that. It'll give us a chance to get a change as well. Fresh bodies and the first pair on the ice. I want to get it to Blum for a really quick one-time ripper, but he's got to hit it. Oh, that never even came close. Who are you passing to? Oh my God. Holy crap, that forechecker came out of nowhere. I thought these guys were sitting in the neutral zone. They're still pressing. Well, they got one aggressive forechecker. Spaling the move. Backstrom's going to hold on to that. Probably a wise idea for him. No, let's hold on to our first line for a second. Let's put the fourth line out for a second. Let them eat some ice time. And then I'm going to take a timeout once we get a whistle soon. Not yet. We need to get inside of 2 minutes for that whistle. Inside of 2 minutes. Bank back to Borg or Blum. Oh, yeah! Oh, that was well timed. What a rip by Blum. Bar down. And it's just number 8 on the year for the defenseman. It's been a while since Shea Weber scored, but we don't need Shea Weber when we got Blum just crushing pucks like that at the top of the circle. Just hope that does not hit you. That's on your wish list. That goal was on my wish list for the whole game. It took us a long time to find number 2, but we've tied the game. We're going to float this in. On net, is he paying attention? Backstrom's paying attention, and he will take a faceoff, and we'll stick with his first line. So a little bit of mojo going our way. Paul Gostad has reached 200 career points. That's a nice milestone for him. And you may be moving up the lineup. You might become the third line center. Shea Weber. Oh, the cheek of Wilson is going to be stinging for a bit. But not too bad that he can still get a decent shot on net and a good forechecking play. Retrieval by Craig Smith. He's just looking for the outlet. And now Smith. Who's open? We're going to wrap it down low in the corner. Wilson. Got a spin off of that. Wilson. Oh, Craig Smith was so open and I missed it. I decided to do a stupid deke. That backfired and I had Kostitsyn wide. Was it Kostitsyn or was Craig Smith? Whoever was wide open. I think it was Craig Smith. I just said who it was, and I've already forgotten who it was that was open. Man, Butler's got to come down off that wing and support that play a little bit. That winger can come down and get it. See, if you can just get to that, go. The wing doesn't have to stay locked on to the point. Oh, that was bad. Bad by me. Oh! Okay, Kareen off the boards behind the net. I didn't see what happened entirely. There it is. Wilson. That's a floater. Backstrom's going to cover that. The Wild don't like this. I think that was Suter that sat down Wilson. And no timeout. I contemplated a timeout, but you know what? We'll just put the freshest group on the ice, the third line here, and just try to pound another one in. Rebounds are there. Don't give up on that forechecking effort. Bork, step around. The up and over deke? Why? Okay. How much time left? Clap bomb. Missed it. Stay on that boards. Stay on that side. Force that breakout play to be tougher than it is. On net rebound. I don't like where this is going. Forsberg out of the zone. Hammer it. Oh, into the nutsack of Suter. To end regulation. The Wild only have 17 shots on net through three periods of regulation play. We're in overtime again with a Western Conference team. And we're just trying to bide our time here. Get a game winner. Yes, Wilson in overtime. Didn't even take 30 seconds. And you might be looking at your new first line center, Colin Wilson, coming through in the clutch in OT for the Nashville Predators. Maybe the navy blue jerseys are good luck. That was a great game. That was a hard-fought game. We had to earn every bit of this one. But that's it for the blue jerseys for the season. Are you serious? You can't be serious. This is depressing, bro. Mike Fisher is gone for 6 to 7 weeks. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Six if we're optimistic is playoffs. Let's look at it. Let's look at his exact timetable to return. He's actually scheduled to return before David Legwan, who is gone until the 29th of April. These guys are done until April. And that's rough because this is our top two centers. Mike Fisher and David Legwan are both your number one and number two overall or number one and number two centers. And they're gone. They're gone until playoffs. You'll be lucky to get Mike Fisher back before playoffs. And you'll definitely get Brendan Morrison back. So he's going to be playing some role as a center. But, you know, those are big injuries right there up front at first and second line center. Who plays center now for this team? I guess it's Colin Wilson. Let's take a look. Austin Watson. All right, well, you know, it's official. Colin Wilson, you know, welcome to the first line center position. That makes sense. And Spaling at second line center makes sense. I don't know. I think I like Gostad on the fourth line, but we don't have any options, do we, in terms of scratches? Is Austin Watson the best we have? What is Brandon Yip's face-off rating? It's 65. So how does that compare to Austin Watson? He's a two-way forward center. His face-offs are worse. We would be better off putting Brandon Yip at center. You know what? Hold on. What did it say? 60? Let's look at Forsberg because I'm thinking Philip Forsberg. His face-offs are 60. It doesn't matter. Does anyone have a better ability at center? Halaschuk does. Gabriel Bork could be an option at center. No, Rich Klun, you're not playing center. Gabriel Bork, nope. This is going to remain unchanged, this top six. These wingers, maybe. No, Bobby Butler's not that great at faceoffs. So here's what I'm thinking here. Halaschuk, you're going to go on the third line, and you're just going to play center unless I can call someone up. Maybe we can call someone up, but I think we have called up the best that we have in reserve, like, except for this Chris Mueller guy. He's 60 overall in faceoffs. I don't want that. Rest are all D. Goodness gracious. I should have... Well, okay. We've got free agency. We can take a look, but I think there's just literal scraps in free agency. We'll come back to this screen. Even worse news, free agents are not an option. It's grayed out since we passed the deadline, I guess. So free agents are not an option right now. That's not good. Colin Wilson, you're manning the first line power play, first unit power play. And Nick Spaling. Where's Nick Spaling? So by alphabetical order. So Nick Spaling, you're playing second power play unit center. Unless, like I said, Bork does not have a good fit. No, he does not have a good face-off rating. Spaling, four-man power play. Spaling and Watson at this point. We cannot have, yeah, we cannot have, or not Watson, Wilson, I'm sorry. We cannot have any more injuries at center. We cannot afford this. Colin Wilson is going to be getting so much ice time because he's like the best guy we have left at center. I didn't change that, did I? I put Watson in. I meant to choose Wilson. I'm getting confused now. Wilson, there he is. Wilson, Colin Wilson. You're going to be playing a lot of scenarios for the rest of the season until we can get healthy again. Yourself and Spaling are getting all the ice time because I don't know what else to do at center. I really don't.